What have I done? I've messed it up already. Oh dear. Frozen Minecraft. Let me start this again. Stop that. Well, ladies and gentlemen, if it's working now, that is brilliant. Let me just go and find the chat. Just restart my computer. So, welcome, if you're watching. Welcome. Live streaming. I'm just tinkering in the background, so to speak. And let's just pop the old chat out so I can see it. Beautiful, beautiful. Kadake. Pig in a pocket. Right. So, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, animals, minerals, and vegetables, here we are at in the old Minecraft, so to speak. The old Minecraft. So, here we go. There she is. So, you can actually join us if you are playing Minecraft. Here's Jennifer Avery. There she is. That reminds me. That does remind me. You're all in adventure mode in this little game that we're playing here today. We've got a couple of experiments. So we're actually in a reconstruction of Standfast and Barracks, which is a kind of printing, a kind of fabric printer and design place in Lancaster in the UK. It's part of a historic kind of Minecraft build project that I've been doing. Let me just pop outside the front. Jennifer, you're very welcome to have a little poke about and have a look around if you want to. You probably have seen, so this is the front of it. It's called Behind the Wall, because basically, as you go into Lancaster, there's this big wall on the right-hand side, and people are like, what is behind this wall? And nobody really has known for years and years. But I've got to make a clock up there, clock face up there and stuff like that. Curious Bunny has joined us also in the chat. Jennifer Avery is also kind of, we've got a couple of moderators, chat moderators and stuff like that. So they're going to be helping us with that, and anybody else is more than welcome to come in and join. I haven't got a texture pack on, but normally the texture pack, these glass blocks would be rolls, big rolls of fabric. I'm experimenting. That purple thing over there would be a thingy, what's it, a doobie thingy. A printer, 3D printer. Curious Bunny's joined the game as well. Now, here we are in this thing here. Now, if you go along here, you walk along here, you're going to get given a load of wool blocks, okay? And you can't place, if you're in adventure mode, you can't place the wool blocks anywhere. I don't know if you could pop that out. You can pop that out, which is a bit of a pain. Let me put one back in there. That's okay. But you get given all these wool blocks. Now, you can't place the wool anywhere apart from on the glass, okay? So I've made a little rule with the blocks, okay? They can only be placed on stained glass. If also you want a map, you can come over to this side over here. I've got three command blocks over here. One is give player a map. So if you press, if you click this as well, doink, you get given this map. Unfortunately, it's sort of upside down, which is a bit of a sausage, but there you go. I might turn all this in the background around, and so it's the right way round eventually. But there you go. You can't always. You sometimes get weird things, happening with a thing. Can you TP me to you? Oh yes. Where are you, Curious Bunny? Are you Let's TP Curious Bunny to Wizard Keen. Where were you? Were you somewhere weird? So let's see how else. So this is kind of like a 100-person server, so we can get kind of 100 people in here. So we've got this going on. Now, the shears, yeah, you can't break any of the wool blocks unless you use these special shears, okay? Okay, so it's pretty cool. So it's a pretty safe server for me to sort of let people go. Obviously, you could probably, you know, do whatever, you know, draw whatever you like, but I mean, you have to be pretty persistent in doing that. You can't even place wool on top of wool, so which is pretty awesome. You can't build anything. You can only create two-dimensional artworks, okay, and then use your map to have a little look at them, okay? So you could spell some horrible things, but of course, if you do, I will ban you. So, and you know, and that's just the way it goes. So it's not a fully creative server. It's not kind of this kind of thing, but it should be pretty fun, okay? It should be pretty fun. So we've got this. Hi, everybody. Hello. And it's early days. This is a really early development of it as well. It should be a lot prettier. At the moment, there's not a lot going on. But you are allowed to just basically draw something or kind of create something on this big area over here. It is about 128 blocks square. So just come and have a look. Elliot Woofwoof, I have, don't worry, one day Elliot Woofwoof. Elliot Woofwoof is asking to become a mod, and he did ask to become a mod last time, and what I tend to do is I don't, you know, it takes time, doesn't it, everybody? Curious Bunny, Jennifer Avery, everybody, it takes time, okay, for people to do, you know, it's not instant. So this is another thing over here. So this is about a pattern making thing. So again, walk along here and grab some stuff, alright? And then once you've got to grab some stuff, this is red wool. Now this red wool can only be placed on iron, okay? Once you've placed it down here, it starts to copy itself over there like this. Now what I want to do is I want to be able to then I'm making a little kind of device, a little command block thingy to copy that here, okay? So we'll copy one here, and then the next person will create one, and it will copy there, and the next person. So I've got to make a mechanism that will copy it one step along. So that's yes, you can. Anybody wants to join this server, it's going to be open all week for sort of Saturday. I might change the server for tomorrow, but you can have a little go with that. So have a little look, have a little go, and we can kind of create crazy patterns. Look at that, it's kind of a crazy pattern. So this is my pattern making workshop, and over here we've got this big kind of creative server. Now, you see, I can't place these, those wool blocks over there can't be placed on this glass. They can only be placed on iron. What I've got to do as well, because everybody's going to get slightly hungry, is I've got to make some food for everybody, or turn saturation down. Okay, hello. Elliot Woofwoof, enjoy yourself, join in with stuff, be pleasant, all that kind of stuff, and we'll see how it goes. Are there any rules on the server? At the moment, there aren't any real rules. I mean, you can't actually do much. You can't really damage the place. General rules, this is a kind of a lovely creative area. So what I want people to do eventually, what's going to happen with this, is that we're going to get kind of crazy designs over on that side. Okay, over the next few weeks. And then also people will be able to, I'm going to have more of these available, and people will be able to kind of create larger pictures. Okay, I'm probably going to turn this into something very, very similar to a plot server. Okay, so you can kind of have your own plot and kind of create maps. Each of the maps is on the wall over here, and we can kind of see that some, you know, there's been a little bit of design stuff going out here. Yeah, no swearing. That's right. Basically, Yeah, well, I mean, at the moment it's a totally vanilla server, so that's currently what is going on in here. But if we want to create, if we want to create a kind of a different kind of server, then that's what we might have going on. But currently, this is a little bit of a weird experiment for me, so I just want to kind of invite people along and see what happens. Yeah, no meanie beanies, right? Because we can just. We can just chuck you out. It's as simple as that. Also, I mean, hopefully this is a place where we can inspire you as well. So that's kind of what this is all about too. So have a little go at kind of these things. I'm going to go over here and kind of create some food for everybody as well. I can, because I'm the kind of owner of the server, I can actually change my game mode. But I'm the only one who can. I hope. Let's get a chest and fill it full of food. Let's get some soup, and some bread, and some people like seem to like cooked pork chops. I think make a pork chop sandwich. Jacket potatoes is always very nice. Some beetroot soup, because you know some people don't like mushroom soup. I don't know why. Lots of who's this sausage? Flipper. Flipper's over here. Let's put some food down for everybody, and so you can kind of, oh, there's a chest as well. There you go. Have some food. Another bits and pieces in the tab. Whoa. Okay. Cool. So that's that. Everybody is welcome to. There's enough room over on this side. For lots of people to kind of create some pixel art, so kind of doing pixel art stuff would be great. To do this stuff, remember you can come over to this area over here, and then if you're in adventure mode, you can kind of run along this and pick up all the wool bits, and then you can come over there and do that as well. Yeah, it is only on PC, it's like a private service, it's like a, you know, you had to pay for it, so I'm cool. Excellent. Well, come and have a little go at doing some pixel art. And your pixel art may be used in a print. So this is for an art project that I'm doing in Lancaster. So there's the maps that is looking at. So if we go right at the top like this, you can look at this. And whatever you draw, whatever you make, you plop. If you give yourself a map like this, press that button. There's the map. It's upside down, but that's all right. You can then draw on it and it'll turn up in there, which is pretty cool. Yeah. So there we go. It's horrible. Can you add all the wool colours? I'm thinking of it. I mean, at the moment I've added just a sort of a small selection. I'm thinking about, oh my goodness me, that is awesome. So take a screenshot. So at the moment I'm thinking, you know, these are the kind of basic colours that we've got. Whoa. And I'm thinking about adding more, so it just depends. And I asked everybody earlier on this week, if you like wool to draw and paint with in Minecraft, if you were creating pixel art, or you would like something like clay, stained clay. You know, what's people's favourites, wool or clay? And I think wool kind of, this wool kind of joined. I can't draw. I have Xbox 360. Oh, don't worry, Tyson. It'll be all right. We'll do some Xbox stuff one day, I'm sure. Yeah, the server IP is on the screen. So that was it. My day was pretty good. We actually went to Kendal. I don't know if people know Cumbria at all, but I live in Cumbria in the north of England. And so today we went to Kendal Museum, and there was a kind of a kids' archaeology group there. So Django did a day of archaeology with the group at the Kendal Museum, which was really good. I like wool as well. That's why I've done it. So I probably will put all the wool colours along here, and I thought as well it's fun just to sort of run along here and do all that kind of stuff. Let me go over here. I can quickly look, I've got adventure mode. I can turn myself to venture mode, and then I can run along here. There we go. Cool. So Yeah, don't advertise, Bunny. I don't want to have to. Well, not Bunny. Flip a tab. Because one day what I'll do is Curious Bunny and Jennifer Avery will be kind of modded on the server as well, and then they can kind of just, you know, they can just ban you. It's as easy as that. So basically, that's what we're up to. It's not on Realms, no, it's not on Realms. But that's okay. I entered the IP and it didn't work. Here, let me show you. If I go, I'm going to disconnect. I'm going to go down here. So this is the Minecraft thing. This is all the other places I go to. So if I edit it, you can kind of see here. So basically, what you do is you add a server, okay? Once you've added a server, it'll look like this. So server name, you can put whatever you like in there. And then you type 89.34.96.17 and then a colon, okay, dot and a dot over one another. Then 25624, done. And if it works, you might have to press refresh like that. If it works, then you should get a kind of a green bar pinging. And these are the people who are on there at the moment. And then we can kind of just join it like this. Okay. Yeah, there's Jennifer Avery going completely bananas on the thing. I like it, actually. Thanks. I like it because, underneath here there are basically command blocks. And it says basically give a piece of wall that you can only place on glass to the nearest player. Okay, and that's because you're running along it. That's how it works. It's funny. Thank you, Squid Bucket Gaming. I was thinking about it. A lot of my kind of Let's Plays at the moment have just been pushed to the side. So I do want to get back into kind of doing kind of Let's Plays as well. Okay. I don't know where you've gone. Oh, you're over there. Okay, I'm running. Oh, nice. That's nice, nice, yeah. And look at how quick, look at how cool, kind of cool and quick and easy it is to kind of just change this stuff. And that's what I was thinking, like, if you've got a design, and this is what I want Dragnos in for, because he'd be able to do it really quickly. You'd be able to press a button, and it'll just copy that design over. So that's what I'm going to do by the end of the weekend, is to have this place fixed up. Okay, we're going to fix it up. Brilliant design, by the way, flip a tab. Really, really nice. And hopefully some of these designs we'll be able to take them. Yes, so, yeah, this is... Curious Bunny asked a question on the chat there, which is basically, remember we were talking about a server that you're making. Is this the one? This is the server that I kind of... that I run, basically. So it's kind of... it's my little server. And what I want to do with it is... at the moment, it's for this project here. And then there's going to be another few projects as well. So I want to make this open. But this kind of ends in February. Okay. Then after February, it's kind of... I can either keep it or let it go. You know. So what I want to do if I keep it is then put my Wizard's Realm on here. And make it so that people can kind of come along and have fun with it, and have their own, like you know, Wizard's Realm is like, look at all this stuff that's happening, isn't that cool? Wizard's Realm is basically a neat little place where where I've invited other kind of YouTubers and stuff like that to come and play with me on my realm, and I want the streets on that. Where people can have their own little street and have their own little building and stuff like that. So if you run around here, you can kind of fill the map up, which is pretty cool. Okay, we've got some more people coming, which is cool. And what I might do as well over here on this kind of on the pattern making side of things is I can make a couple of pattern places. I know it's a bit big and boring at the moment, but I'm going to make these walls a bit more interesting. And can also put some... there is no plot at the moment, flipper tab. There's no plot, okay? It's just a free-for-all in the middle at the moment. So this is not a modded server. This is just a server that's running in adventure mode. Super vanilla Minecraft. And we're using command blocks and some of the kind of cool things that you can do with command blocks. Well, Ninja Boy's made a point saying I should have staff on here. Well, people shouldn't be able to build at all. Yeah. I know, it's really cool. Your Pokeball is excellent. Look at this thing. It looks really, really good. This one's making a little smiley face. It's awesome. Very, very, very cool. Thank you so much. It's awesome. So some people are super talented. And hopefully we'll get... oh, a screeny. Wait, who wants a screeny? Epic Craft. We should come in. But what I'm thinking about doing is I'm also got another map as well that's coming out very shortly. So this is what I'm going to put that other map. This is my experiment. Okay, hello. This is my experiment. So we'll be definitely be doing kind of this is an experiment today in today's stream, and then tomorrow I've got another map that I want to kind of share with everybody. Yes. Okay. Yeah. No. It's possible, but obviously it's something I've got to do. Tomorrow, I'm going to put my Bernheim map on. Can I have one? I don't know what you mean. Can you have one? There's nine dogs completely going berserk over here. So, what's your theory, Epic Craft Charlie? Who knows about the stuff? I think if this becomes something that people want to partake in, like a Wizard's Realm, then you can definitely, you know, that will be in March, March and April of this year. So that's when that's going to happen. But for now, it's just this is a place for art projects that I do in Minecraft. So that is what's going on. So if we look over here, we can kind of see on this board over here some of the smiley faces and some of the kind of stuff that people are producing, and we can kind of see it live as well. Another kind of key thing here is if you grab yourself a map, you can kind of see what's going on with the map as well. You can kind of look down at it as well. So obviously, because it's upside down, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all of this structure and put it on the other side. So this place actually works the right way around, because at the moment it's the wrong way around, and I think it'd be better if it was the right way around. So I don't know if anybody has done any map making before. So what is with the numbers on the floor? That's a good question. So let me just change my game mode to creative, and I'll fly up and I'll show you. So the numbers were really to kind of remind me, and I was thinking about doing this kind of thing but on a much larger scale. So I don't know if this might bore you or absolutely to tears, but anyway, this is the nerdy bit of my Minecraft. This Minecraft map perfectly matches the space on the floor. Okay, this is map zero. Okay, if we go over here, we can see that this is map zero. So map zero, and any Minecraft map, any new Minecraft map, is 128 blocks wide and deep. Okay, if we were to kind of think about breaking that into parts, half of 128 is 64, half of 64 is 32, half of 32 is 16, and half of 16 is 8. So what I was trying to do is I was trying to think about what was the smallest kind of area that you could kind of produce that then could be copied and turned into a giant pattern. And that would be one of them, but I had to use so many command blocks, it was going a bit mental, and so I turned that kind of idea into this kind of idea, which is much more palatable and a bit more easier for me to kind of deal with. And again, this is a small 8x8 area down here as well, which actually works pretty well when you duplicate it up. So Epic Craft Charlie says, "Hey Keem, my theory is that Hit the Target is the next villain in Wonder Quest." Well, that's a good theory, I'll tell you that. Yes, actually, Ninja, you will have to have staff. Ninja's boy says you have to have staff because they will need to do /ban, but that needs a plugin. Actually, it doesn't need a plugin. Vanilla Minecraft actually has some amazing, amazing kind of, you know, already in it here at like this. So I could kind of basically, if I give people certain permissions. like, you know, Curious Bunny and Jennifer, who I know quite well, I could give them permission and they could kick people off the server. So they could do that, and the kick lasts for a particular length of time. And then another one is as well, they could actually ban people. So you can actually ban an IP as well. And that ban IP thing works as well. No one can ban at the moment, only me. And that's because I'm on the server at the same time. Keen help, it's not let me break blocks. I put the wrong wool in the wrong place. What you need, they call me Mr. Chips, is these shears. Only these shears can do that. So basically, I've made shears that are the only thing that can kind of do it. So that's how this is working. We are actually in a vanilla Minecraft server with no mods running, and yet you can only build one block high. Okay, like okay, I can put something down there. I can't. Oh, I can put. Oh, it's because I'm in creative mode. Yes. If I was like you guys, and in adventure mode. Okay. Once I'm in adventure mode, I can't place. I can only place wool on glass, any kind of stained glass. I can't even break any blocks. No blocks can break. You can fall off. Indeed. We do need a plugin. Now, I actually had Ninja Boy's pretty expert at this kind of stuff. I don't know whether you run servers or not, Ninja Boy, but obviously you're pretty clever about all this stuff. There is a way of I've run a couple of other servers before. And the way I've run other servers is we can actually spam the chat ourselves with a command block. And so even if you write into the chat, it whizzes past so fast that it just disappears. So there are good ways of stopping the chat from being spammed. But I would like, you know, I would like kind of some. That's the great thing about mods, I think, is that you can actually have mods that stop people. Here's Mr. Wiz. Stop people from swearing and things like that. Just using kind of words and stuff like that. Epic Craft Charlie's birthday is tomorrow, so happy birthday for tomorrow. I hope you do get everything you desire. Present-wise, you know? Present-wise. I'm just going to go into creative mode again. And have a little fly-up, see what people are kind of creating. There's some really good things here. So, I've put this up to basically get people on the server and also to kind of test out if this works. So I think this works quite well. I don't think we need, like, what would you like to build on? Okay. I'm just reading Ninja Boy's chat in the thing. So I can either get, I want people to kind of draw on a map, okay? I think that's important. This is my only server, Mr. Wiz, or Mrs. Wiz, or Ms. Wiz. It's not really bad if you really like Jacksepticeye. Although he's super high energy, isn't he? My goodness me. No worries. Okay, we've got a kind of cool thing. So I think things I've got to do, my to-do list is more wool. More wool blocks. Let me go down here. Let me get grab a sign. Because what I'll do is I'll probably keep this on. It's Jennifer Avery hiding behind the corner. More wool blocks. More wool blocks, okay. Add brown wool. I think we need What else do we need? We need a play area. A play meet area. Okay. Maybe some hide and seek. Hide seek game. Staff. Okay. I think this is my... I've literally never been in survival. More plots. Plots. Okay. Who's this? Nine dog 999. Oh, did you? You've created this. Look at the, this. Is let's have a look upside down. We can kind of see there. Nine dog 999 in the upper right hand corner, which is pretty cool. Look at all this stuff. Background color for the map. You need to add in a unicorn statue. Ranks. My goodness, Mr. Wiz Chips would like ranks. I suppose we could have ranks, couldn't we? I wonder if there's a way. You see, I like doing everything in vanilla. that's what I kind of like doing. But I suppose we might need some. The trouble with mods is that sometimes mods make command blocks not work good. That's the only trouble with command blocks. With mods, is that they stop. I stop my beautiful command block weird stuff. Well, yeah, I know. We could do... Is there a way, but with plugins? There is a way, Keem, but with plugins. Yeah, I know. I know. But it's all with plugins, isn't it? Like, you know, you could write a plugin that only allowed you to do this. But then all the kind of wonderful stuff that I've done with my command block, I'd have to get a team of people. And I can't afford a team of people right now. It's just little old me. Woohoo! I think sometimes this is also kind of interesting because not having everything that you at your fingertips sometimes makes people more creative. And this is also an experiment. This is also an art project. So it's not, it's something that will come and go. Okay, so it's not permanent. But I think it is quite fun. Let's see how many we got here. Look at all these people. I'm amazed. With your squid head and your lovely suit there. Well, we'll see. People are going to start asking if they can be staff and all this kind of stuff. And at the moment, here's a question for you. If you were me, how would you get to choose staff if you were running a server? Okay, how would you do it? I know that kind of turns the whole thing around, but it's an interesting question. And I have run servers before, kind of private servers for kind of homeschoolers and stuff like that. And my goodness me, we had all sorts of nonsense going on there. And people were banned and all sorts of stuff. Mums and dads were getting involved and stuff like that. Thank you, Jennifer. I appreciate that. And so, you know, have a little think about that kind of stuff. Often, you see, sometimes what happens with the Minecraft server is that people get a bit power crazy. I don't know if you've ever... Someone's given me a spot to eat. Thank you so much. People can go a bit power crazy. Or people can have stuff going on in their lives and everything goes a bit mental for them, okay? Which is okay. I'm Squid Bucket Gaming. Nice to meet you, Coon. Nice to meet you too, Mr. Squid Bucket. So sometimes you've got to be responsible. Like, if I gave people staff, then I would be kind of responsible for them, okay? Okay, because be a member of the team. Yes, follow me over here. Here, some food in here. There's some food, everybody. Let's have a read. Whatever it is, I've had past experience of being staff. Yeah, exactly. And that's kind of why I kind of, you know, why you're mods, really. So it takes a little bit of time to trust people. And just to make sure that if you do trust people with a certain amount of power, that they don't go completely power crazy. Okay. So once I ran a server and I gave someone permissions to run the server, and then that person kind of showed off that they were kind of really cool and let all their friends have like epic weapons and all sorts of nonsense and stuff like that, and it unbalanced the game and made it difficult for everybody to have a good time, and that was a real shame. And so that's why it's good to be sensible about these things, and to make sure that people have got support systems in place anyway, because often people who go power crazy often need support themselves, you know. Oh, cool. Well, let me read all this stuff as well, because people are. I'll make something that stops people from getting hungry. Here's someone, a new person. Hello. I like your skin. It's very, very, very retro. It's awesome. I'll make. Let's put some more. Let's put a load of. I wonder if I can. I don't think I can middle click a chest, can I? Let's just get this chest over here and get some food for everybody. Yeah, if you want to record, you're very welcome to record on this server while we're doing this kind of stuff. If you want to kind of do a little thing, I'm absolutely fine with that. So let's just get some bread and puddings and stuff like that. Do you play Pocket Edition? Yes and no. Yes and no, I do play Pocket Edition. people are like, what's in the chests? I haven't put anything in the chest yet. Let's grab some more food. Let's grab cake. There we go, get some golden apples out. Get some steak out. Lots of pumpkin pie, some jacket potatoes. Some beetroot. Some cooked mutton, some more roast chicken. I wish you could have a stack of mushroom stew. There's many, many real disappointment with this kind of stuff. You can't have more mushroom stew. What other servers did you play on? Okay, so here I'm just going to disconnect very, very briefly so you can kind of see. So I've got Choo Choo's, I've got Minecraft server, which is like the Blockworks one. I've got Island Life, which is kind of an Island Life server, which is kind of a little Let's Play I did with some other people as well. The Minecraft server, that's the one I'm playing at the moment. Cracktopia, of course. Hypixel. The Enchanted Isle. And a copy of the one I'm in at the moment. So those are the servers that I kind of generally play on all the time. So there we go. Yes, I have. So Tyson Walker said, "Add it clear." So I've got a clear item thing over here, and that's just basically for me, so I can kind of quickly. Oh, I just cleared Jennifer's. I just cleared your thing. There we go. I just a clear thing, but I'll probably put that over there and make it a little bit more interesting to kind of to be kind of interested in. I've also got a give player map and also adventure mode. That's for me. Let's have a look. Oh, cool. Oh my gosh, this is awesome. You guys are amazing. So what I think I'll do is, I mean, there's a lot. Look at how much pixel art. I mean, how long have we been going? I don't even know how long we've been going. 20 minutes? 30 minutes? An hour, if that. So look at the kind of stuff that people have got done so far, which has been amazing. I've got a nice list of kind of comments over here. No, the trouble with hackers and is that hackers kind of spoil it for everybody. I'm stuck now. Okay, let's just get Wiz. Let's TP. To Daniel Snartling. There you go. You should be fine. Oh, I should think season 3 will be coming. Don't you worry about that. Don't you look at all these apples on the floor. Yeah, people use Hacksaw and all sorts of other things. The thing about this is, you know, I get, what happens is the server basically backs up every 5 minutes. Okay. So it's on a regular kind of backup thing. It's not going to be like Cracktopia. It's not going to attract hundreds of people at a time. However, there are quite a few people here at the same time. It is a bit of an art experiment at the end of the day. It should only attract a few people at a time. The creative sausages, as we call you, who are amazing. Oh, good. Well, I did teleport you, Wiz. So that's what's... that's what's going to go on. Oh dear. Oh yeah, you probably fell down. Let me fly off. I'll show you how. Yeah, there are some people. What is happening here, Keen? Says Daniel Snatting. This is underneath. If you get trapped here, walk off the edge and you will die. I say the way to choose staff is to have all of us staff, Keen. That might be a way. So you can walk off the edge and then die. Okay, it's only a little way up. So Daniel Snatling is asking what's happening. So Daniel, this is my Minecraft server. Okay, it's a Minecraft server that I kind of have owned for a while, and it houses different art projects that I do. So everybody is actually at the moment having a little play in my latest art project, which is called Stand Fast and Barracks. And Stand Fast and Barracks looks a lot like this, okay? And it's actually based in Lancaster. This is a clock tower. It should have a clock there. I'm going to make that. someone's saying, can I have brown wool? Yes, I'll get there. So that is probably what's going to happen. Oh, nine dogs back. So this project is about this place, and it's a heritage place, but also it's a real place in Lancaster. And what they do in Lancaster is they design and print fabrics. My project is basically to get all of the Minecraft community, who are kind of super creative, to come in and kind of be creative and do some pixel art and have fun like here. So this is a big area for kind of group pixel art, which should be quite good fun. And then also over here, there's a little experiment which we're doing, which is basically pattern making. So whatever blocks you put down here, you can kind of see they make a pattern over there in the corner. And I will eventually be making a little mechanic that allows you to save your patterns one by one, and it'll just go off into the distance like that. PyTrain, you can build pretty much whatever you want, but there are rules, okay? The rules are based on the materials. So over on this side, PyTrain, if you're in, you can run along here and grab all these different bits of wool. The wool can only be placed on glass, so you can only actually make two-dimensional pixel art here. Okay, you can't place wool on wool, that won't work. You can only draw flat stuff. If you make a mistake, okay, with this stuff, you can then use some shears, which I've given you, and the shears will only break wool. Okay, so so we're in vanilla Minecraft. Shamok, come here, please. I have a question. So we're in vanilla Minecraft using command blocks to do this. Okay. I don't know where you are. Who was asking? The Wacko Shamrock was asking. Can someone TP me? Yeah, I can TP. I'm the only person who can TP at the moment, so there is no staff at the moment, Daniel Snatling. TP. Monkey Child. To Daniel Snatling. There we go. Oh, here's the Wacko Shamrock. Hello. You're right in front of me now. Keen, how come when I shear wool, it doesn't let me place the wool that I pick up? Ah, because... look at this guy. Because it probably changes. It depends. I was stuck under the map. Yes, it's not a fully finished map. Okay, this is another thing I've got to warn you all about. We are, yes, just go, just yeah. So PyTrain, get your shears back. Okay. Can you come on pocket round? Maybe if I have time, just come back here and grab some shears along here. That's it. There you go. There's your shears. Who will we staff? Now, this is a good question. Probably people that I know, first of all, and then we'll take it from there. Okay, you know. So you never know. You never know. Look at this person here. It's awesome work down the floor. This is amazing. I'm absolutely amazed that we've got so many people on here at the same time, and you're all getting stuck in with some creativity. Obviously, I think, as Jennifer Avery done there. Yeah, so what needs to happen is, I think we need to make things bigger. Help me, I'm stuck. Let's just sort of TP someone who gets stuck. Do, 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 do. I be stuck. Okay, flipper. Flipper tab to. There we go. I've got you out of being stuck. We need more big, lots more plots. Lots more plots. Okay, so that's what's going on. That's why you're all here, to basically help me produce this map in a way. Because if you have people on, and you're all trying things out, you're all making mistakes, and you know, basically some people have fallen off, you know, which is normal. Then we can kind of, then I can work out what's going wrong with it. There's Mr. Snoutling. Yes, indeed, Jennifer Avery is like, yes. Well, you see, I've got nice big open areas over here. And also, a lot of this is very plain. You see, in this area here as well, what's going to happen is, there's people come in, there's going to be information and other bits and pieces. So you kind of walk in here, you'll kind of read about the kind of area in here, and then you'll be able to interact with stuff. So in this room, this will be you'll be able to see some of the workings of Standfast and Barracks. So I've got some this red stained glass isn't actually red stained glass. I've got a texture pack which makes it look like rolls of fabric, which is really cool. And then over on this side as well, I'm going to have a digital printer and stuff like that. But of course, all this is you know, people can fall off the. Be careful! you've fallen now. You're in nowhere land. Come back up here. You're called Wolfman. Right, come, I'm going to TP you back up here. Wolf, be careful. Careful now, everybody. Careful. Okay, TP Wolfman. Wolfman. To, yeah, you can come back up there. There we go. So, although this looks like a bit of purple glass, it is. Oh, look, you've been able to put. That's right, because there's a rule. So, there we go. So we're going to have, like, more interesting stuff. And then, again, more interesting stuff here. And then this area, although it's going to be reasonably flat and people are going to be in adventure mode, you won't get hungry. I'll be able to put a command block that runs a saturation effect, so you never get hungry. And also, it also will run a health effect as well. You'll get instant health every, like, 20 seconds or something like that. So that is how we're going to kind of do that kind of stuff. And then people can come in and build stuff. And then this will be going running for about maybe 2-3 weeks. And I'll be coming in and doing kind of live streams and other bits and pieces with it as well. And then hopefully some of your stuff. I mean, some of the stuff that you've made today, I can guarantee this is actually going to go and be printed on some fabric at Standfast as well. Okay. So some of the stuff that you've created today is going to be actually used in my project. Okay. Would you be awesome? Oh no, I'm stuck at the bottom of the map. Oh no. TP. pipeline to up there. There we go. Okay, there we go. So Wolfman's crouching down here, which is really cool. Thank you very much for coming. Yes, I know. I know. Well, again, you know, I'm just trying to say, you know, it's not the end of the world. But yeah, I haven't quite decided how it's going to look. Everybody's more than welcome to go down to the bottom of the map. Maybe I should make some a ladder or something like that. Don't. Oh, you've got an effect on you. Crackified gamer. Let's try and get some game. Crackified gamer. Let's just TP you. Pop you up somewhere. Where can we see the final project? The final project is going to be on show in Lancaster at Lancaster Museum. And that's going to be in March. And then of course I'll be making videos about it as well for everybody who it doesn't A, live in the UK. B, can't get to Lancaster. C, doesn't want to go outdoors and just wants to stay in and watch videos on YouTube. I'm there for you, don't you worry. This map will be gone. Oh, Daniel's not in. This map will be going offline later on tonight. Okay, I will carry on building some stuff, and all the work that everybody's done will remain. Okay, and I'll just come in and do some other bits and pieces. Okay, it'd be nice to try and figure out a way of saving your work. Especially on this thing, because at the moment anybody can come along and just change it. I know, it's amazing. So Jennifer's just said the map is getting really full. So if we look over here, flip a tab. You may not be able to build with the wall that you've got already. There are two different types of wool. The wool on this side only affects on glass. Panda stuck at the bottom. They call me Chips. The wool on that side only goes on to iron. Okay, I may change all this. So come along here and grab some wool from this side, and you're about to kind of make some woolly stuff here. The will you ever have a modded server? Probably. I tell you what. What's going to probably happen, right, is that once this art project is finished, the Wizard's Realm, yeah. Oh, let's just get. Oh, there we go. The Wizard's Realm will be put onto this server, and at that point, I'm going to get Curious Bunny to help me mod the server. I need some help. Basically, because I know a little bit, but I don't know a lot. And so that'll be a 100-person server, and people can come in and make plots and things like that. So it'll be a plot server, and that'll be where I do my Wizard's Realm stuff. Okay, so there's going to be a few places that you can kind of build stuff. It'd be a normal plot server, but based on my Wizard's Realm world. So there'll be like little roads around everywhere as well. And that's how that's going to be. Because I love plot servers. I love Cracktopia. I think Cracktopia is excellent. But I also like the idea of kind of making a community and then having a theme around. So basically, the server becomes a little city. So that you can build whatever you like. But if you build like shops and things like that, and add stories and things like that, then that's kind of cool. You know, found an inappropriate build. Oh, well, there you go. Thank you. Well, it's going to happen, unfortunately. It's going to happen. But if you guys can take it away, that'd be perfect. That is super. Anyway, the night is still young. What I'm going to do shortly is, obviously, you've all done... I know. But I've got friends here. I've got friends who are very vigilant. If people want to kind of have a picture, let's go right to the front and then... I hope so. Yeah, Stamp's been busy recently, so I'll be talking to. So, Crackify Gamer said, "Am I going to play any more mini games with Stamps?" Yeah, hopefully. If anybody wants a picture, now is the time to grab a little selfie with me. So, if you want to come over here and grab a selfie, that'd be great. That is going to happen, unfortunately, Jennifer. At this stage, this kind of experiment, you know, people may break stuff and do all that kind of stuff. So that's just going to have to actually, that's just going to happen. But what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to turn, the server will be closed shortly. Okay. I'll save the build and make sure everybody can have a look at it. If people want to have a copy of it, I'll put a copy of this on Dropbox and you can download it for yourself, and I'll put that in the description of this video when it goes up on YouTube. Is that okay? Okay. So thanks very much for coming and saying hi to everybody and coming on the server and testing out. Look how many of you there are. So many. I was absolutely thrilled to bits that you're all here. So thanks very much for popping in. For kind of saying hi and stuff like that. So thanks very much, and I will see you all again shortly. I'll be doing another stream tomorrow, but tomorrow we're going to be doing a stream on my other project, which is called Bernheim, which is about 9 stories. So you can have a little go on that. That also requires a resource pack as well. So do consider downloading a resource pack, and we'll see how that goes too. So until next time, thanks very much for watching. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, do consider subscribing. We kind of do this kind of thing all the time. I'm doing more and more live streaming than ever before, so we'll be doing that kind of stuff. If you've got any suggestions about other kind of videos that you'd like to see me produce and stuff like that, let me know in the comments section below of this video as well. That'd be really cool. I know, I can see the pattern from here. It's awesome. I will be kicking everybody off the server in approximately 5 minutes and shutting the server down, saving the server, putting the server onto Dropbox, and then you can have a copy of whatever's been built here for yourselves after that, okay? So from this video, there'll be a download link. Thank you very much to Jennifer, Avery, and for Curious Bunny for kind of turning up and for kind of just supporting the live stream as well, and also to Daniel Snoutling as well, who's also been part of the moderator team as well. So you are awesome. I will see you all later. Thanks very much. Yeah, I'm gonna kick everybody. Everybody's gonna go off, and the server will be shut down for the night. Okay. Take very, very good care of yourselves, and I'll see you all tomorrow. This server will be put up, but it'll be a different map on it. Okay. So until then, thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all soon. Bye. See, I'm still going. Really, I'm still going. The live stream is still happening, but we're gonna actually stop it. So. I'm gonna go to my website, and I'm gonna give them a few more minutes on there as well. Thanks, everybody. We'll just sneak onto Cracktopia very quickly. Sneak on here. Okay, here we are. Here we are in Cracktopia. It's snowing, which is a little bit embarrassing because winter has stopped. Let's basically put it like this. Now, so that's where I am now. I'm in Cracktopia. So let's see if anybody turns up really quickly. For one thing. So here we go, the fire train straight away. Here he is. I've got to change all this stuff. So I'm not sure what to do. We've got to change it to snowing. We don't want it to snow anymore. Here's Jennifer Avery. Thank you very much for popping by. So this is why I like Cracktopia. Now, you're going to have to remind me, folks, how do I stop it from snowing? Because I can't remember. Plot sun. Thank you. Oh, two things. Not rain. Ah, what happened? Oh. There we go. Lovely, lovely, lovely. So there we go. Perfect. Oh, we've got welcome rulebook and command book to get started. Well, that's quite good. So I think what I'm going to do here is, obviously, I like my mushroom house, but I think we've got to kind of get rid of Mr. Snowman. And I like Jennifer's house over here that she made over there. That's pretty awesome. The duck pond is awesome as well. But we're going to get rid of the snowman. We're going to make something that is more spring-like. I think we're heading towards spring, so that's kind of what I'm going to be doing. But I'm not going to be doing it today. I'm going to be doing it tomorrow. Thanks, Curious Bunny. Later, it will be tomorrow. I think I'll probably start off with some Cracktopia, and then I'll move swiftly on to my other thing as well, to my other kind of project. So again, I am actually going to go because I've got my dinner ready downstairs. So thanks very much for watching. I hope everybody's having an awesome time, and I'll see you all soon. All right, thank you. Bye.